Now in the morning session, what we did in the first period, formula based derivative, right? 2x by 1 plus x square, that type of questions we have done. Now derivatives of implicit functions. Before doing this one, to find derivative of the question, previously question having only x values, right? Let y is equals to be used today. Now what we have to do? Whenever we have any equation which has x and y both variables in a line, in a equation, what we'll do is we'll differentiate both sides directly. Such questions are known as implicit functions with respect to x. So what we'll write with respect to x, d by dx we'll take to first term, d by dx to second term, and d by dx to third term. D by dx of 0 also. X square derivative is n into x power n minus 1 plus y square derivative. 2 into y power 2 minus 1 into
0.
Yeah. D by dx of y. See, d by dx of y cube, if I, we are doing, this is x, we are considering this to be x. X power n is n into x power n minus 1 into d by dx of whatever we have considered, that thing we have to write. For x, we will not do like that. X means x is a variable. So we, whenever we will consider anything apart from x other than x, that time we will write like this. So 2x plus 2y dy by dx equals to 0. To find dy by dx, take the term of dy by dx on left side and set the other terms to right side. So dy by dx equals to minus 2x divided by 2y. Okay. Now, this one, differentiating both sides with respect to x, d by dx of x power 4 plus d by dx of y power 4, a square outside, only variables are x and y values, equals to d by dx of 0. What we have done, whenever any implicit function is given to equation given, differentiating all the terms, constants are taken out. X power 4 is 4 into x power 4 minus 1. Whereas y power 4 means we will consider this one as x, n into x power n minus 1 into d by dx of y minus a square into which form?
Uniform.
U d by dx of v plus v d by dx of u equals to 0. Whenever two multiples are there, see, when two, both of them should be x or x, y also. Y is also one variable, so uniform. Now this is 4x cube, 4y cube into dy by dx, minus a square is multiplied to first one, d by dx of y is dy by dx only, we not have any formula, minus a square into y, into dy by dx of x is how much?
1.
Equal to? This a square is multiplied to first one and a square is multiplied to second one with minus 9. Now the terms with dy by dx should be taken common. In these two terms we have dy by dx. So dy by dx and taking common. So what is the term remains?
4y
minus a square equals to, say other terms to right side without dy by dx. Minus a square y comes here.
Plus a square y.
4x cube comes here.
Minus
4x cube. We need dy by dx. That's the reason two times we saw dy by dx. That's why we are taking common. So single dy by dx we have to keep here. A square y minus 4x cube divided by 4y cube minus a square x. This one. Y is equals to x power y. Base and power are having variables. So what we'll do?
Applying
law one two six. Whatever base not take always base in a bracket. Log y equals to y comes before log.
Y log
x. Now differentiating both sides. D by dx of log y. Y log log y derivative
1 by
d by dx of y. Reason log x is 1 by x because we are treating this one as x, so 1 by x into
d by
other than x should be taken once again. Here u we form u log x into d by dx of y is dy by dx. Now to find dy by dx, you have to check how many dy by dx given.
Two.
Two times. Take the d by dx to left side to take common. Here. Y by x. Now dy by dx common. Nothing means by one. Take LCM into 1 minus y log x. Suppose any multiple we are sending to right side, it becomes reverse. Suppose any multiple goes to the denominator, any denominator value goes to the multiple. So if anything is given along with dy by dx equal to, we are sending that to right side, any multiple, it will be reverse. What we have to do here, any multiple a by b goes that side becomes b by a. Okay, you can conclude by writing d by dx equals to y square by x into 1 plus y log. Both the terms are there with equal to symbol in between. What we have to do now? Yes, apply log on both sides. We are differentiating, so we have to take log. This x comes before log. Sin y comes here before log.
Differentiating.
Not differentiating both sides. D by dx of
x
d by dx of sin y log x. This is uniform. This is also uniform. U uniform. Expanded both the both left and right side at a time. Then we have to differentiate accordingly. D by dx is for log y, not log x. Log x means 1 by x dy. But log y is 1 by y. D by dx of y also you should write. Then log y into derivative of x is 1. This is sin y. D by dx of log x is 1 by x. This one is log x. D by dx of sin is cos y into
d by dx of y.
D by dx of y. What is the reason for writing y again?
Yes,
in place of x we have y, that's why that is taken once again. Now we need to find dy by dx. So wherever dy by dx is there, we have to follow the terms and take to one side. Already 1 by y dy by dx is there. Okay. Left side, right side we have log x
cos y
dy by dx. Equals here what we have?
Sin
y by x. Plus log by comes here?
Minus log by.
Minus log by. By nothing means 1. Here dy by dx common.
1 by y.
1 by y minus
log x
cos y.
Cos y. Equals to?
Sin
y.
Sin x. Minus log
by. Now we will consider LCM here inside the multiple. 1 minus y into log x into cos y.
X
sin y minus
x
into log y. Better we take brackets for that one. Dy by dx equals to
sin y minus
sin y
minus
log x log y by x into
y
by now in one more way we can write it. This is the answer actually. Or you can write dy by dx. Because they are multiple now. Y by x I am writing here in one bracket. Into sin y minus x log y by 1 minus log x cos y. Both are same. Only presentation is different. Multiples now we can present this one and that one in two brackets. This is the question given. If means condition, then means show that. So we need to find dy by dx indirectly. So whatever given, we'll write that.
X
power log y equals to log x. Take in bracket, this also comes in bracket. Because base and power has x and y variables, what we'll do? We'll apply log on both sides. Log, I'm applying to log x. Okay, this log y comes here.
Log
of log x. Now differentiating both sides. D by dx of log y into log x. D by dx of log x. U v form. U. D by dx of v. Plus v. d by dx of u. equals to log x is 1 by x into inner function derivative.
D by dx of log x.
Okay, don't think this is uniform. Reason? Log x is not there. Log of whatever value we have to consider that to be x, 1 by x into whatever we have considered, that we have to write once again.
This is log y. Derivative of log x is 1 by x. This is log x. 1 by log y derivative is?
Y by
dx. Equals to 1 by log x. Derivative of log x is? 1 by x.
Now, wherever d by dx is there, only one type is there. We'll write on left side.
Log x
into 1 by y means log x by y. dy by dx equals to 1 by log x into x is, don't write log x square. X log x we have to write. Then from that side one log value comes here.
Minus log y by x.
Log y by x. This is log x by y. dy by dx equals to LCM. Total thing we'll write. X log x is LCM, so x log x is there, x log x is there, 1 will write, minus, x and x cancel, log x goes there, log x into log y, once again check the LCM, we'll write x log x and x, x is repeated only one time we should write, log x is there, so total thing we'll write here. Now check the denominator, this denominator cancelled with this, whatever remains write it, denominator cancel the denominator with this one, what remains? Log x, we'll apply log x to this one, log x into log 1. Now this is multiple, this is the bracket.
dy by dx
equals to
1 minus log x log y by x log x into
bracket into
y by log x.
Now you can write down the pattern of the answer. Y by x separated, y by x separately we'll write into log x log y by log x into log x, log square x or log x square. So this is dy by dx. Okay. Now what is given in this one? X power y equals to y power x. Apply log on both sides. So that y comes before log.
Y log x is equal to x log y.
Now differentiating both sides. D by dx of y log x. D by dx of x log y. Now this is, these two terms are uniform. On left hand side we have u d by dx of v plus we just split on formula of u v. Here also u v, u d by dx of v. Don't write direct formulas and all. Plus v d by dx of u. Now y into log x derivative is 1 by x plus log x into
1 by
y dy by dx. D by dx of y is dy by dx of y. Here x into log y derivative is
1 by y.
1 by y d by dx of y plus
log
y into 1. Now we have dy by dx two times. Left side I'll write whatever dy by dx term.
Minus.
Then right side we have to take one term from right side. This x plus x by y dy by dx comes here. So this is plus na, it comes to left side becomes negative.
Minus.
Log y. This y by x comes here.
Minus
y by x. Dy by dx common.
Log
x minus x by y. Here same thing. Log y minus y by x. Now LCM in the bracket of dy by dx.
Y
log x minus x.
X log
y minus y. This is also a bracket. Dy by dx equals to x log y minus y by x. This goes that side.
Y by x.
This is the answer, but answer is in different pattern, so you have to write down that same pattern.
Y by x.
Single values we will write outside. And double values are there, we will write in the bracket. Okay. We have x power 2 by 3 plus y power 2 by 3 is a power 2 by 3. Then we need to show that simple question. Whatever given, we write this one. This is given to us. No. Base power x are not there, so differentiating both sides. D by dx we have to take on left side plus d by dx on right side. Okay, left side. Another term, then right side. Now differentiating values, then this one dividing x power 2 by 3.
2 by 3 into x, 2 by 3 minus 1.
This one?
2 by 3 into y, 2 by 3 minus 1.
We are considering this one to be x power n. So n into x power n minus 1, then whatever we have considered that we should write once again. Is there any x coming that one?
No.
That is 0. 2 by 3 minus 1. X and y are variable. If x is not there, y is not there, so that is 0. 2 by 3 minus 1. After LCM it is?
Minus
1 by 3. 2 by 3 into y power, 2 by 3 minus 1 is? After LCM. Then this is dy by dx. Now take the term which has dy by dx on left side, remaining you should send on right side. 2 by 3 y power
minus
1 by 3 dy by dx equals to minus 2 by 3 x power x power minus 1 by 3. Dy by dx equals to minus 2 by 3 x power minus 1 by 3 divided by 2 by 3 y power minus 1 by 3. Dy by dx equals to minus negative degrees are there. Suppose a power minus n by b power minus n is there. this negative degree comes to numerator becomes positive, this negative degree comes to the denominator become positive. Degrees are negative. Here power is negative, now x power negative value. It comes to the, this is minus sign, outside minus sign. This y comes to numerator. This x comes to numerator. So dy by dx equals to minus of, both are having 1 by 3 as power, so whole power 1 by 3. Once we have 1 by 3, 1 by 3 is also known as cube root. What is 1 by 3?
Cube root.
So they have given a minus of cube root of y by x. We will get this. Root 1 minus y, x square root 1 minus y square is given to us. First we write given values. This is very very important one. Whenever I am writing important means, you have to remember something in that question. What is that? One minus x square, one minus y square. By seeing the two terms, x is sine a, y is sine b. You have to remember. Now substitute in this condition. One minus sine square b minus sine b. One minus sine square is cos square a. Square root is given, cos a. One minus sine square b is cos square b. Square root cancelled. Cos b, a into sin a minus sin b. Now 1a formulas, cos c plus cos d. Two cos c plus d by 2 into cos c minus d by 2. Sin c minus sin d. Again, 2 cos c plus d by 2, sin c minus d by 2. See, if you don't know the formula, learn for this problem. Two formulas are required. Learn that formula. Substitute here. Cos c plus cos d. 2 cos c plus d by 2 into cos c minus d by 2. But in right side, we have a into sin c minus sin d. 2 cos c plus d by 2 again. Sin c minus d by 2. Now multiples cancelled from both sides. 2 is common. Cos a by 2 is common. So remaining thing is cos a minus b by 2. That sin a minus b by 2 comes to the denominator. Right side we have a. Cos by sin is cot. Cot a minus b by 2 equals to a. Cot goes right side. A minus b by 2 equal to cot inverse a. A minus b is 2 is cross multiplied. Check this one clear once again. We have to practice this problem 3 times. According to my calculation expected for this year. Whenever we find root 1 minus x square, root 1 minus y square in the question, consider x to be sin a and y to be sin b. Okay. X as sin a, y as sin b. Now you have substituted here. I got cos a and cos b, sin a and sin b. Cos c plus cos b formula expansion, sin c minus sin d formula expansion. After expanding, cancel like terms from both sides. Remaining terms I am taking here and whatever trigonometry left denominator. Right say a. Cos by sin is cot. Remember this also. Cot a minus b by 2. Now what we I have done is cot I have sent to right side. Cot inverse a. This multiple I sent to right side. I have A and B here. Whenever I have A, A can be written as sin inverse x. If I have b, sin inverse y. So this is sin inverse x minus sin inverse y equal to. Now we are differentiating both sides with respect to x. So d by dx of sin inverse x, d by dx of sin inverse y, d by dx of 2 cot inverse a. This is 1 by root of 1 minus x square sin inverse y into y. Why we have to take d by dx of y once again? Sin inverse x means x value itself. 1 by root of 1 minus x square. D by dx of sin inverse y means we are treating this one as x. So 1 by root of 1 minus x square into whatever we have treated as x, once again we should write that. Then d by dx of right side value is 0. Why 0? There is no x present in that. Now taking the term which has dy by dx on left side with the sign, whatever sign it has, everything, then this plus value goes that side. Both side minus sign cancelled. Dy by dx we need, so this goes to the numerator. Root 1 minus y square by root 1 minus x square. Then square. Leave that one up. Single root, you can form a single root to this.